That's right. I finally got to go into the REM, the most advanced, high-tech train in the entire country and probably the entire continent. It was so cool. It was so exciting. And I hope you guys will be excited as I was. And I hope you'll enjoy this video. We're here in Gare Centrale in Montreal, and we're going to be riding the new REM, the newest train in Canada. And it's really cool.
So, hi, I'm Thomas. I'm from Montreal. And I do...
Thomas is the guide for today. So you find yourself in Montreal. What's the transit context here? So this city is the second largest city in Canada and the largest city in the province of Quebec, where just around half the population, or 4 million people, live in Greater Montreal. So that's pretty big. Now, Montreal currently has a heavy rail subway known as the Montreal Metro that's ran by the SCM. It uses rubber tire metro cars similar to some Paris counterpart lines. In fact, those are the lines that inspired the Montreal Metro. The REM was actually not built just by the government. It was built by the CDPQ, a pension fund. Pension funds in Canada have a lot of investment opportunities, and a long-term investment like transit is a good one for these kinds of organizations. It also kind of pushed the CDPQ to make this a financially feasible project, and it was completed much faster and much more on budget than most other projects. So, the REM, the Reseau Express Metropolitan. What makes this train so special? Isn't it just any other subway? I mean, the underground station we're at right now is like any other subway station, isn't it? Next departure screens, fare gates. So why is the REM so special? Well, I'm glad you asked. This video, we're gonna cover all of the specific, special, little quirks and attributes of the REM that make it the most modern and advanced train in all of Canada, and the exciting things that we have for more trains like it across the nation. Now, to quickly start before the actual train, even in the station we see some improvements, such as the wayfinding. In Montreal, especially compared to its Toronto counterpart, wayfinding is very well integrated and simple across the entire region. In fact, the ARTM, the regional body, has design standards that are very simple and standardized and pretty nice to look at as well. This is much better than Toronto, which is only starting to do this. The REM, in fact, has a double line on the map that makes it unique from the other lines, and that is because this train is unique from the rest of the Montreal Metro.
Bienvenue à bord du REM. Direction A1. Brossard. Prochaine station, Île des Sœurs.
Now, as this train glides out into the bustling metropolis that is Montreal on an elevated guideway, which is so cool, by the way, you'll notice on the left side of the screen a new Via Rail train. These are the Siemens Charger sets, also known as the Venture sets, and they're gorgeous, first of all. And second of all, seeing this for the first time, while also on the REM for the first time, was a surreal experience that I hope you guys will have at least an equivalent experience like this in your lives and in your cities. It makes you feel like progress is happening, and it's now, and it's tangible, and that is an amazing feeling. It feels like we're going forward, and we aren't stagnating. And also being from Toronto, where massive changes are happening, I just can only imagine what would happen if change like this happened everywhere. And change is happening everywhere. You just have to look for the people advocating for this change and making this change happen, and support them. Go to your local community meetings, vote for mayoral candidates, do your research. It can really help and make a difference. I believe we can have a better continent if we work together. Another great thing for foamers out there is that you constantly see other REM trains passing by you, which you can see on the left side here, as well as the Via and EXO train yards, which I've also shown in this video. There's just so much train stuff happening. It's so amazing. And it's also elevated, so you can see so much. We're here at the terminal station for the REM, and it's currently part of the first segment that's already open, which is 18 minutes end-to-end. I don't remember the amount of kilometers. 18 minutes end-to-end, by the way, is incredibly fast. Something you'll really notice in this next clip. All right, so now we're approaching and getting close to like the highway bridge, and this is the part where the train goes really, really fast. In fact, this footage is not sped up, and we're not even really at the max speed. You can tell by the way that we're passing some of the cars on the highway.
That's actually probably a new speed record. This is insanely fast. I've never seen the train going that fast except maybe on open, well, on the like pre-opening day. Normally it goes at like 85 max here. It went up to 91.
Do you have a speed counter?
Oh.
Whoa. That's like crazy fast.
Lyon, du quartier.
Now, the stations of the REM are either two side platforms or one center platform, like most stations in the world.
Les portes s'ouvriront sur le côté gauche.
As well, on this initial segment, a lot of the stations are highway median stations. However, platform screen doors allows these stations to be climate controlled and generally soundproofed, unlike their counterparts in, say, Chicago or Philadelphia, that are not nearly as bearable to be in and are not exactly pleasant. In addition, the general aspect of the REM being elevated and having really open and elevated stations as well means that it's super easy to get a lot of these super cool shots from inside the station and see the trains from up close. And the ticket machines are a lot better than the ones on the metro.
Certain, like, I don't know. I mean, we can always try. That's the control center. And at the back, there's the maintenance center.
The black one?
Hmm?
The one in the, like, the black facade?
Yeah. Cool. The, like, a gray thing. But it's a small maintenance center because the big one is not open yet.
Cool.
You may also notice that the REM stations here are very, very simple, easy to get around, and, you know, not too complicated, which is part of what helped the REM be a project that was very cheap compared to many other transit projects in the continent and on time.
Well, the Poissel station is a park and ride station as well as a bus terminal station. There's a lot of electric chargers, station things there.
So there's about 3,000 parking spots in this entire parking lot, but typically park and rides aren't that bad, especially because we are in the suburbs of Montreal, and also because this is a terminal station, a lot of people who don't live right beside this might drive here. But we're gonna go look at the bus terminal now.
So here we're at the bus terminal, en Poissel.
This is the bus network of the RTL, which is for Longueuil. And basically they messed up a couple of things on the map here. For example, this station, they have the right name of the station, but it's not at the right place. It should be more like here. Then here they switched the two metro stations, but it's a bit of a problem.
Tim Horton's over there soon.
And then here is the bus terminal, which has a covered area and little wings with buses.
This is actually a lot nicer than most terminals in...
And they even have heating ones at the top.
Interesting. Look at all of that parking. And this is actually the smaller bus terminal. The bigger one's at Panama, but they look similar, right?
Yeah, they're similar. I would say probably the one at Panama is maybe... double the size,
and that's
the same design. Basically, they just like took the design once and they just like made it bigger.
Sort of the people go from Panama to Gaston right now.
Yeah,
I want to be broken. That's what?
How did it break?
I don't know.
Train over there, and they're automated light metro trains, which means that there's no driver, and that means they always stop at the same place, which is what allows platform screen doors on this line, which is not seen anywhere else in Montreal or actually in Canada right now. In fact, the Vancouver SkyTrain, which is also an automated light metro, does not have platform screen doors, but instead has detectors that make sure that nothing is on the tracks when it goes through. So, because of this, this means that the REM has lower operation costs than most other trains, just because you don't have to pay drivers, which is one of the biggest costs of a transit line operation.
There are two types of REM trains. There's the two-car sets and the four-car sets, and you could walk through each two-car sets. So the four-car one is two of those, and you can walk through each couple of sets, but not the whole train.
REM is also used more as a regional train rather than a metro itself. And so the stations are more spread out than on metro lines, and also it parallels, in fact, one of the lines of the Montreal Metro right now. But it facilitates longer regional travels, and in fact, the REM, the first line that's opening, the De Montagne line, is made as a replacement for the De Montagne EXO line, because EXO is not very good.
Also, fun fact, they specifically requested that the window be custom made so that a child could see out the window, just like here, which is really cute and I like that.
The REM trains have a maximum speed of around 100 kilometers per hour on the network, and it does that on the bridge. However, the average speed that they're going for on the entire network is about 50 to 51 kilometers per hour, and that's the goal. So, in Gaspard, mainly it exists as a terminus for via trains coming from Toronto and Windsor, as well as for some of the regional trains, the EXO lines. Now, Montreal is different from Toronto, and that's because there is no through running station here, and so actually the suburban trains come into two different terminals, and this is the terminal for one of them. Now, one of the criticisms of Gaspard is that there isn't actually a metro station here, it's actually just a short walk away. And the REM is actually the first time that...
Oh. Weirdest things about the train station Gare Centrale is that the entrance is in a parking lot? And like, it was really hard to find.
Thomas, I found out that there used to be more signage here, and the RTM took down the signage because it wasn't official, like, RTM signage, which is like, that's crazy. But yeah, I did get lost on the way here, so we should have more signage.
Les portes s'ouvriront sur le côté.